How's it going? Mikey here, and today I'm going to show you the fastest and easiest way to get the nuked out title in Black Ops 2. That is, win a flawless game of free-for-all without using any lethal score streaks. Since this title requires you to go flawless, you will need to leave a game if you die once to lower the chance of you rejoining the same lobby. And to get a faster connection, delete all your DLC. Unlike Modern Warfare 3, there is no option to disable DLC. Don't worry, you can re-download all your maps at any time for free by going into your purchase history. As a side benefit, your enemy will usually be easier, as very casual players hardly ever buy the map packs. If you join a game in progress, I would usually back out if the top player has over 5 kills. Next up is score streaks. All your kills must be with your weapon, so your best options are UAV and VSAT to help find the enemy, and counter UAV slows everyone else down from finding each other. Now is our class. I found the AN-94 to be the best all-around weapon for this challenge. For your attachments, the extended clip is forgiving for those with bad aim, and it allows you to spray down your target if they run behind cover. For your second attachment, add the adjustable stock. You will be playing very cautious and aiming down your sights a majority of the time. The stock allows you to move faster while aiming and makes pre-firing around corners much easier. The stock combined with the extended clip makes it really easy for you to back out of a losing gunfight, as you can move into cover while spraying and praying. Next up is perks. You want to force the enemy to take you out with their weapon. Flak jacket and tactical mask will cancel out any random explosives, flashes, stuns that are very common in Call of Duty. Our next must-have perks are toughness to win our gunfights and scavenger to replenish our shock charges. Speaking of shock charges, let's move on to our playstyle to get a flawless gameplay. Whatever map you land on, you're going to want to establish an area that has two major entry points and cover those points with shock charges. These will act like your proximity alarms, and you should listen out for the sound they make when someone with the tac mask breaks one of them, as they will still be able to rush you. As soon as the target is dead, plant a new charge and reload under cover. If you're hurt, wait until you're back to full health before patrolling your area again. Keep moving around, looking at spawn points, but don't move too far away from your shock charges. You can't sit still in a corner because you'll be wasting time and letting other players catch up. Once you get your VSAT, that is when you can become much more aggressive. If you notice a player is in a corner aiming at you, don't challenge him and instead focus on the other players. This class forces the enemy to mostly use their bullets to kill you, but you need to recognize a good portion of this game is luck and connection speeds, so don't let it frustrate you too much. Leave a comment below on what title I should do next. If you want to play with me, follow me on Twitter or Facebook, links in the description. Please take 3 seconds to rate the video, and I will see you guys next time. And this is viewers of the month for August. Now this is where I take my top 3 favorite videos created by you guys. So if you want me to feature your video, all you gotta do is follow me on Twitter and read the description below. So let's get started. So first up, we have a character tree, and yeah, this isn't Call of Duty, this is GTA. I tell you guys, you can submit any video as long as it's gaming related. And here we have character tree, he's playing GTA with his friends. And the reason why I like this video,